Sometimes I forget what Americana is for me. The nostalgia for simple ignorance, folksy twangs, and small town minds. I've been spoiled by progressivism and like-minded, college-educated, socially conscious surroundings. And I forget that Americana for me is African Americana, an alternative reality. A parallel universe that runs alongside Mayberry where blacks cower. But in 2008, I got a brief reminder. It means staying quiet, staying low, keeping your head on a swivel. African Americana means watching your back and not driving alone. And so I got a big old slice of nostalgia as an Obama campaign staffer. I was dropped into East Cleveland for the final stretch of the campaign. And every day, that old familiar feeling would creep back as I drove around the neighborhoods.
When are you coming back to New York?
The day after the campaign. But you make me feel like I never left. Half of the office is staffed with New Yorkers.
How's, Cleveland?
Oh, I don't want to be a snob.
That bad, huh?
Do you remember RoboCop?
One or two.
The one where all hope was lost. Probably two. Some parts of this town remind me of the set design.
Except without the robotic killing machine.
You haven't met the cops here. This city is a bombed out crater, Will, and they filled in the places between the rubble with fast food chains and fried chicken shacks and check cashing stores and churches. It's like a gangster rap album of the 1990s. And the only thing that holds people together isn't politics, God, or family. It's sports. It's the one thing people can gather over and celebrate.
Sounds dangerous.
Well, we have a surefire shield.
What's that?
Obama. We cover our cars in Obama insignias and make sure we have an Obama window shield prominently in the back. Oh, and you make sure you walk around with some Obama stuff. Hats, pins, shirts.
That's smart. Let them know you're on their side.
No. It lets people know that we're poor and that we're trying to do something about it.
Yes, we can. 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 Yes, we can.
Obama's name is a shield from gangs. It was a bullseye for cops. Our campaign bus was stopped, searched, and confiscated by the local police just a few minutes after leaving the lot for the first time. Our staffers were held in custody. But we're tough New Yorkers. We don't back down. We just started making jokes about it. I thought about coming up with a punch card for police stops. On the fifth stop, you can get a free McDonald's shake. This help keeps the spirits up when you get pulled over. Cop stop.
That was an illegal turn.
I didn't see that, but okay. Cop stop.
Why is your trunk so low?
It's filled with campaign lint.
It looks suspicious.
Officer, I'd like to give you a free Obama t-shirt and bumper sticker as a gift from me to you.
You're funny. Pop the trunk.
Do you wish to search the trunk? Because I believe you're going to need something called a search warrant, or at least more probable cause in a lower carriage. Just kidding. Just a little comeback. Oh, man. Constitutional rights. The trunk is open. Take a few bumper stickers and hats.
Rodney King! Rodney King! Rodney King! Rodney King! Rodney King! Rodney King!
You play the risks in African Americana because there is a thin line between being a college-educated, uppity, black New Yorker and a crying wreck in an East Cleveland jail.
I can't believe it's almost 3 a.m. You staffers work like this every day?
7 days a week. and in a few hours we're gonna get up and do it all over again. You're lucky you're a volunteer. You can leave whenever you want.
There's a car that's following us.
Ugh, I know. It's a cop. It was in the campaign office parking lot.
Fuck, I hate cops.
Well, I don't know about
it. I fucking hate cops!
Okay. Those are some strong feelings there, Kate. Why do you hate cops so much?
Never mind. Why is he following us?
Just be Obama. Cool. And cop. So, Kate, is that a Long Island accent?
Nah, man. Patterson, New Jersey. Where you at?
Brooklyn.
Oh, I always wanted to go to Brooklyn. You from there?
No, I moved there to be a writer.
Pig's still following us. Why don't he just pull us over?
Don't know. Do you have any brothers?
Had a brother. He was killed.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Killed in a traffic stop. By a pig! Huh?
Don't you just love those horrific moments of cosmic irony? Kate, do you believe in God?
Hell no!
Great, me neither. I'm a Buddhist.
Oh, like that Tina Turner, no home, no rent, no shit.
No. I mean, that's one part of it, but I practice something called...
Shit!
To be continued.
Why are you pulling us over?
It's a little dark in here. I wouldn't want an accidental flash or something to be mistaken by a nervous cop.
Why would he be nervous? He's the one with a gun!
Yes, but he's by himself. It's 3 a.m. and he's pulling over two black people he doesn't know from Adam. Up ahead is a well-lit major intersection. I'll pull up there. And then I will take my wallet out of my pocket and place both hands on the steering wheel.
Why didn't you pull over when I turned on my siren?
I couldn't see anything, officer.
You stop! When I tell you to stop!
Officer, is there a reason why we're getting pulled over?
Hey, shut the fuck up! Here's my license. Giving, morality, patience, effort, concentration, and wisdom.
What?
My spiritual practice. It's called the Six Perfections.
What the fuck does that have to do with anything?
You're in a difficult situation. You're supposed to practice the Six Perfections. Giving. Giving my license. Morality. Following the law. Patience. Not getting angry. Effort. Exerting mental energy to stay calm. Concentration. Meditating on one thing.
What's that?
Going home. I want to go home. You want to go home. So let's do everything we have to so that we can go home. In wisdom, your brother.
What the fuck do you know about my brother, huh? He was 20 years old working two jobs. He was gonna go back to school. He wasn't just some piece of shit junkie like Rodney King. He was gonna be somebody. So what the fuck would you know about that, huh?
You're gonna learn from him and then you're going to teach me. That's the wisdom. You're going to teach me how to play this game how so that we can go home.
What if he arrests us?
I can't control that. So let's just sit here and meditate.
You're really, really weird.
And so we sat there in meditative silence at 2:50 a.m. on East Cleveland Back Road. I thought about Kate's brother and these cops. And then I remembered something. When our officer was approaching, he was nervous. He couldn't have been older than 25 or 26. He probably had a young wife or a girlfriend. And he most definitely did not want to be out here with us. He wanted to go home. Prayers do matter. Then this should have had three times as much power because we all wanted the same thing.
There you go, Mr. Clayton. turn that switch there?
I'm back the other way.
That's good. You had your dimmers on.
Oh, well, thank you.
You followed us out of the parking lot before we hit the road because our lights were dim?
Kate!
Fine. I'm shutting up.
Have a good night.
Yeah.
Have a great night, officer. Proves that he was never really a RoboCop asshole to begin with.
What?
Never mind. Long story.
Six perfections? I remember that.
Between the houses are abandoned houses, burned structures waiting to be knocked down, and empty lots. It's a place that's lost its golden touch generations ago. It is a slice of African Americana. And it's all that follows me all these years later. And even here, change is possible. That night, on that dark back road, I saw proof of that.